Hey everyone, welcome back. Hopefully you all had a wonderful weekend. It is officially July at this point, which means we are about a month away from teasers and reveals surrounding the next premium Call of Duty. And I saw a tweet last night that actually inspired me to make this video. It's coming from the gaming revolution, and this is what he had to say. Be ultra weary of the Modern Warfare 3 marketing this year. It's so easy to get caught up in the hype train and be let down by misleading or even accurate statements at the time of them being said, but then plans don't get fulfilled due to upper management. I wouldn't be surprised if we hear statements like, "We've heard your feedback on Modern Warfare 2 and we are listening this time. We have the most expansive post-launch plan for the new era of Call of Duty. Relive the original Modern Warfare 2 with a bunch of classic maps back for COD's anniversary." I am 100% in agreement with what TGR is saying here. You got your expectation and then you have the reality of the situation. Expectation for Modern Warfare 2 was absolutely through the roof. For a vast majority of the community that did not enjoy Vanguard, they were really hoping for a 180 of the series. And unfortunately, that just didn't seem to happen. While Modern Warfare 2 did a lot right and still does a lot right to this day, there is no denying that the support, the communication, the interaction, the community feedback is just not being listened to. It's very, very strange to see. And I thought for sure it couldn't get worse than what happened during Vanguard's year. But boy, were we wrong. It's way worse. And the thing is, we continue to see the team at Infinity Ward expand. They just announced last week that there's going to be a brand new Infinity Ward Studios opening up alongside Digital Legends out in Barcelona. Now, this is a weird situation to find ourselves in because not only are they going to be preparing for the launch of Warzone Mobile, but they're also going to be continuing their work side by side on Call of Duty, the premium stuff that we see released every single year. With the new studio comes new employees, and I'm hoping that that translates into more communication, more community outreach, more live streams, more developer sit-downs, blog posts, and so much that we need to see as a community, which has been completely crickets all year long. I don't know how else to explain it, but the point is, Vanguard was already a bad year, right? For many people. I liked the game. I'm not going to lie. I liked it. I think it was a good game. I think that there were times where it was really boring and there were definitely times where we were upset and there was, you know, times to be critical. But for majority of the year, I think they did really, really good, especially with what they were dealt. And Sledgehammer seems to be pretty good with dealing with short-term situations. And that's pretty much what we're going to be finding ourselves in this year again with Modern Warfare 3. It's a short-term situation. They're basically turning around in the span of a year or maybe just a little bit over a year to pump out this next Call of Duty game. So what am I personally expecting? Well, I'm expecting a quality product. I'm expecting there to be support for multiplayer, specifically in Modern Warfare 2 map rotation, because all of those maps were allegedly supposed to come with this current game that we're all playing. But I also expect there to be its fair share of problems. I expect within a year of development, they definitely need time to fix specific things. Is this one of those situations where a live service game is going to release with a bunch of problems and it will be fixed over the course of months, like we're beta testers in a way? Yeah, most likely. Most likely. At this point, that's just what I've come to expect, personally. I wish that I can sit here and tell you that we're going to have the most fully detailed, in-depth prestige mode that we've ever seen before. A better progression system than we've ever had, with seasons spanning across multiple months that give us so much content as players that we can just play and play and play for hours and hours and hours every single day, month, year, for multiple years and never get bored. I wish I could tell you that. I wish Call of Duty would go that route, but unfortunately, that's just not the reality of the situation. And to be completely fair, I really don't think we're going to see major Call of Duty changes, and I'm talking major gameplay changes, major progression changes, maybe even prestige changes, weapon changes, maybe even to an extent UI changes, because that's been one of the complaints this year as well. I don't think we're going to see that until Treyarch's game, personally. At that point, they'd have a total of 4 years into the project that they're working on. And that gets me so hyped. It gets me so excited just to know that they've had an extended amount of time to work on whatever they're working on. And I think the biggest blow to my heart would definitely be if Treyarch just stumbles and they aren't able to capitalize on the time that they've been given in order to create something new. that would be one of the saddest situations we would find ourselves in as players of the Call of Duty franchise. This is the first time where they're really going to see what an extended amount of development time can do for a game the size of Call of Duty, and specifically when we're talking about live service, which is just... it's a whole other rabbit hole in itself, but I'm just really rooting for the team at Treyarch. But not only that, I'm also rooting for the team over at Sledgehammer, because one of the things that I loved about Modern Warfare 2 was the campaign itself, and to know that we're going to be getting a continuation to Modern Warfare 2 right after we just had it the year previous, that we've never seen that before in Call of Duty, period. So normally we have to wait 2, maybe 3 years before we actually see the continuation of the story. Getting it year after year, that's actually a nice little treat. And I am looking forward to seeing what happens in that story and what the future holds there. I would also be lying if I said I wasn't excited for Modern Warfare 2 maps to be coming back in all of their glory with updated graphics for the current generation. But then again, that's just the COD fanboy in me, because in reality, it's maps that we've seen time and time again. It's not really anything new. It's not anything fancy. And the other thing I need to point out is it's not a Modern Warfare 2 remake. I need to make that very clear. It's not a remake of Modern Warfare 2. It's not going to have the same abilities. It's not going to have the same perks. It's not going to have the same nuance that that game did all those years ago. So I definitely 100% have to bring up the whole marketing beat that's probably going to be to celebrate the 20th anniversary of Call of Duty, have all these Modern Warfare 2 maps. That's probably how they're going to frame it. But in reality, we know that that wasn't supposed to be the case. It was supposed to be a 2-year cycle. We were supposed to get these maps with Modern Warfare 2, and that's just not what happened. It grew too big to the point where now they just turned it into a full-fledged Call of Duty game, and we're going to have to pay $70 for it. I'm just hoping that we do get multiplayer support this year, especially if they're going to be talking about the 20th anniversary of Call of Duty. Warzone was not there for 20 years, but what was there for a majority of those 20 years was multiplayer. That's really what put Call of Duty on the map. So if we're truly going to be celebrating 20 years of Call of Duty, I'd like to see them truly celebrate with legacy features like a legacy prestige mode. I'd like to see them add stuff that we enjoyed from the past, like in previous Call of Duty games, like customizable kill streaks. I'd love to see them do more stuff like that. But once again, this is that expectations versus reality situation, right? It's not going to be the case. I already know that that's not going to happen. We're dealing with a 1-year time cycle, and how much they can get done in that 1 year, plus what they're going to have throughout the development time while the game is live, because we know that they're going to be making changes on the fly and updating and, of course, adding things over the course of seasons, just like we've seen in previous years. I don't know, man. I really hope for the best. I wish Sledgehammer the best. I know that they can do it. They've pulled magic out of their ass before, and I'm looking to see just exactly what they plan on doing with that magic. And the thing is, I've talked about how nostalgia is being just sucked dry at this point. You can only really market nostalgia to a certain extent, and Modern Warfare 2 has really zapped the life out of that, combining bundles and really kind of focusing on that mainly over gameplay, which to me is just a big no-no when we're talking about a game like Call of Duty. It just really hasn't helped. It's only hurt, to be completely honest. And while they're making a lot of that money in the short term, long term, it's just not going to look good for them because players are going to continuously fall off. I mean, I've even seen some of y'all in my comment section saying, I don't even play this game anymore. I'm just here to support Prestige. And for those of you that are out here, thank you. I appreciate it. But I feel it too, man. I've taken an extended break away from Modern Warfare 2, and I can even realize now that it's just, there's nothing happening. Gameplay and features and updates like that have become second fiddle to the almighty bundle. So unless you're willing to cough up $20 every single day just to have a new blueprint in your hands, unfortunately, you're going to be stuck with the same content, the same camos, the same everything that we've had for weeks and weeks and weeks since the last content update. And even then, that brought very few things for multiplayer, at least. So anyway, I don't want to complain about this anymore. I mean, this is the reason why I took a break from the game. I'm just here to let you know, keep your expectations in check when it comes to COD 2023. Keep it in check because we don't know what's going to happen in the future. We don't know where this game is going to go when it comes to its live service. We don't know what's going to happen with the current offerings that exist in MW2. Is DMZ going to continue under Sledgehammer? Is it going to continue to be developed, but it's going to stay in Modern Warfare 2, similar to how Warzone was, right? Like, Warzone stuck with Modern Warfare 2019 until Warzone 2.0. Is it going to be the same way? I don't really know. I think it's just a really confusing situation we all find ourselves in right now, and even more confusing for the Call of Duty development teams. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I really appreciate y'all joining me for this conversation. Let me know all of the things that you would like to see for COD 2023. And of course, what are you expecting for a yearly developed Call of Duty title? And this one in specific, having only about a year to be developed. Thank you all so much for watching. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.